The COVID-19 task force sitting in Kampala implored Ugandans to embrace vaccination and get booster shots for more effective control of the pandemic.
So the answer to this is continuous sensitization so that our people are mobilized to go and get vaccinated.
The Ministry of Health is racing against time to ensure the remaining vaccines are consumed before the expiry date. A status report presented in the meeting indicated a marked fall in COVID-19 cases, signaling the containment of the pandemic.
We all need to survive, and therefore the need for us to campaign seriously, intensively, so that our people can survive, so that all of us can survive.
The reason why we should increase vaccination is not only preventing illnesses, but also trying to prevent other variants coming on, so that we do not go back into where we were.
Other salient issues discussed include whether or not to close the COVID-19 testing laboratory at Entebbe International Airport. It was resolved that this laboratory be closed since testing at the airport before departure was no longer a requirement.
The laboratory at the airport is not being used. We are not using it. We are using our various laboratories that are around because we are only looking at vaccination certificates. Except for those who are not vaccinated, we require the COVID-19 testing.
The meeting also agreed that there is need for increased sensitization and engagement with the population about COVID-19. The report about money collected from the public to support COVID-19 management was deferred.
The governor is aware that we need national interventions, especially for specific sectors that were impacted by COVID, like education. Think of people with vehicles who were supplying, their vehicles are literally, they've written them off. So we've got a lot of businesses that are on their knees, and we need to deliberate on how we can support them.
The Minister for Finance, Matia Kasaija, said a comprehensive report will be provided at a later date. Kasaija also guided on what businesses should do to recover from the effects of COVID-19.
The impression I've seen is that we must be back where we were before. We shall get there, but we shall get there progressively. You know, it's like when you fall sick, they take you to hospital. Then you recover, but you don't recover fully. So there is a period of recuperation or something like that. You doctors, yes, please. For the small businesses, there is money that is in the bank waiting for them.
Much as the order to put on masks was lifted, the task force advised that the public should continue putting them on until such a time when the country achieves the recommended 70% of people to be vaccinated. Cases of side effects of COVID-19 vaccination and other claims that the vaccines were brought to control population growth have greatly affected vaccination uptake in the country.
Try as much as possible to keep on your masks, and unless you are, of course, outside, and get boosted. We have booster doses for all of you. You can access it from KCCA near here, Makerere University Hospital, any hospital, whether Mulago, public, private, wherever you want to go.
Dr. Henry Chobe, the National Incident Manager for COVID-19 at the Ministry of Health, Uganda, says that the government plans to vaccinate the children from the age of 12 to 17 during the coming holidays to ensure the country is safe from COVID-19.
And would like the National Task Force to adopt and implement the suggested whole government approach to tackle complacence and vaccine hesitance and in vaccination of children starting 12 to 17 years in the school holidays, which are just a few weeks away.
The COVID-19 National Task Force will meet next week to plan for the way forward. Story by Ismail Kasoha for the news.